who has been chafing at the bit to respond since Eric in the last segment charged the Obama administration with breaking the bank when it comes to Obamacare and the federal budget. Okay, Professor, you're on.
Let me respond by saying, number one, I think health care is the best thing that's happened to this country during my adult life. Finally, we're becoming a first world country when it comes to telling people that there's not going to be pre-existing conditions that disqualify them, that they're not going to have to give up their personal doctors if they want to pay for them, but that every American, like every person in Massachusetts, has the right to health care. The United States Constitution provides for the general welfare. Are you now saying that the Commerce Clause would not allow the United States Supreme Court, even Chief Justice Roberts, upheld it and under the Commerce Clause and under the taxing power? So we can have that debate, but you don't engage in extortion to shut down the government. And on the other side, the left shouldn't engage in threatening to criminalize this conduct by threatening sedition the way Move On does.
I challenge you to show me in this document where it says that the government can tell me I have to buy a good or a service. And the way they did it and the way they got around it was instead of calling it a fee, they called it a tax.
I'll tell you where it's the same provision of the Constitution that says your child has to be vaccinated. It's the same provision of the Constitution that says your son has to serve in the armed forces. We sometimes have to compel people to do things that they may not choose to do in the general interest of the United States. Here you're being compelled to do something that's
totally
going to help
disagree.
You.
Let's talk about the other part of your comment. Your comment was that Senator Cruz upheld the American economy, held the American economy, took hostages, whatever terms you use. But
Extortion.
Great. Same thing. So what are fiscal conservatives supposed to do if Congress holds the
check? Who's
filibustering
now? Go ahead. All right, finish your point.
If the Constitution, and it does, gives the checkbook, the strings, the pen to write the checks to Congress, and Congress is to the House, and the House is held by Republicans, and Republicans want to say, before I sign up another trillion or two or $3 trillion in debt, I wanted to discuss how we spend that trillion or two or three in debt, how America spends it. Why? They're playing by the rules, sir.
Absolutely. Absolutely. And let me tell you how other countries now deal with this. For example, recently in Israel, they tried to do the same thing, and they passed a new statute saying that if the Knesset, the Congress, refuses to fund the government, automatically certain things come into play. And that's the way it should work here. There shouldn't, either side should not be able to extort. I don't approve of the filibuster. I believe in democracy. And democracy means you run for election. Let me finish.
Do people write a check out to Harvard and have you teach their children constitutional law? Because you're basically saying
impose my moderator's position here because we're running out of time. I finally want to ask you. Immigration reform. Ted Cruz has a soft target with immigration reform. Don't you agree, Eric, that he can sabotage President Obama's aspiration and in doing so damage GOP prospects because Latino voters won't go to the Republican Party?
I'm interested in to hear what Ted Cruz's full plan is. I'm interested to hear what Marco Rubio's plan is. I have an alternate plan. Geraldo, you and I have talked about the privatize the whole border.
So I have an idea.
And then if you want to let the 11 million people who are here stay here, that's fine, but when they turn 18 or if they're already 18, they have to serve a year in the military.
What's that a bad idea? And in terms of immigration reform, Professor, do you want to cap up the conversation?
I think immigration reform is one of the most important things that we have in this country. I wouldn't be here today, Geraldo. You wouldn't be here today. Half of Americans, half of the Nobel Prize winners wouldn't be here. Many of my family came here illegally during the Holocaust. They became great and wonderful citizens. We are a nation of immigrants. Let's maintain that tradition and keep our borders open, consistent with national security, the safety and the welfare of this country. So I welcome the Obama plan, and I oppose the Cruz plan.
All right. That's Professor Alan Dershowitz. I give you the last word.
The last word is, I think, Senator Cruz did everything by the book, sir, the book that you teach every single day to your students. I apologize if it was rude to say that. I can't believe parents write checks to Harvard to have them have you teach their kids constitutional law. I just think
you apologize, and then you said it again.
I think that your interpretation of the Constitution varies vastly and widely from mine.
That's my friend of me, Eric Bolling. I love being on TV with that guy, as I do you, Professor. Taking the Stand, Thank the you. Autobiography, ladies and gentlemen, and we shall return.